There are different customs and habits around the world. Indian women like to wear nose rings. Both men and women in ancient Egypt like to shave their heads and wear wigs, and people in some African countries like to use the top of their heads to carry objects. Night crawling is an ancient Japanese custom that dates back to the Feudal era. It involves a young man sneaking into a woman's bedroom at night to engage in intimate relations, usually with the intention of pursuing a romantic relationship or marriage. Yobai was practiced in rural areas and small villages, where living arrangements were often communal, and young people had limited opportunities to interact with the opposite sex. While the custom might seem strange or intrusive by modern standards, it was an accepted part of courtship during that time. The families of the young people involved were usually aware of these nocturnal visits, and the women could choose whether to accept or reject the advances. In some cases, the women would signal their willingness or refusal by leaving their door open or closed, respectively. However, there are some historical accounts that suggest married women may have also participated in yobai under certain circumstances. In some rural communities where the practice was more common, it was believed that engaging in yobai could bring good fortune, fertility, or even improve a couple's relationship. In these cases, a husband might permit or even encourage his wife to participate in yobai as a means to seek these benefits. When it began, the origins of the custom. So far, Japan has experienced 10 years of development. The first era is the earliest Yayoi era, and night climbing was produced at this time and gradually prevailed in the second era, the Asuka era. At that time, although the Japanese island was a tiny place, there were more than 100 tribal countries, large and small. Few people left their ancestral lands, and many people only went as far as the edge of the tribal territory in their lives. At that time, there was only one key to the prosperity and decline of a tribe, and that was whose population was large. Therefore, in order to reproduce the population, the female resources are efficiently used. The ancient villages in Japan began to have the embryonic form of the custom of night climbing. Later in the Asuka era, it was enriched and perfected, and gradually formed a custom passed down from generation to generation. This point has been fully verified in the classic novel, The Tale of Genji by Murasaki Shikibu in Japan. At that time, the Japanese prince Genji often used the folk custom of night crawling to go to and from different women's boudoirs at night. Even climbed into the stepmother's room, incest gave birth to Emperor Lenguin. The royal family took the lead, and the courtiers and common people naturally followed suit. The style of night crawling has been prevalent in Japan for thousands of years. Since the northern and southern dynasties, under the leadership of the royal family and ministers in Japanese society, the custom of night climbing has intensified. At that time, conflicts often broke out between multiple men due to the same destination. In order to avoid these unnecessary conflicts and embarrassments, some villages have formulated rules to regulate such behaviors. For example, according to the later rules, the men need to draw lots to decide who will stay with the woman's consent. Those left behind will continue, while those eliminated can only hope for better luck in the next draw or simply climb to other destinations. Some villages even have explicit requirements for married women and husbands to participate in night climbing. Later, even if the husband knew that his wife was staying with someone else, he generally would not object to it. This was due to custom. Also, because he also has the right to be a member of night crawl. People have beauty and ugliness. Night crawling objects, of course, any man would choose a beautiful woman. In this way, some women will be like a market in front of the door, while some women will be left out in front of the door. The reason why night crawling was spread and allowed was to multiply the population and increase the labor force in the village. In order to reconcile the contradictions of climbing because of people and unevenness of heat and cold, some villages have formulated a system of drawing lots by group. To put it simply, the men and women in the village are separated, and the men draw lots to decide where to climb that night. Whoever is drawn can be chosen. You can't refuse or behave on your own just because you don't like it. If there is a violation, the village head will serve you according to village rules, and the consequences will be serious. In the Edo period of Japan, with the development of cities and the rise of towns, social division of labor and class differentiation became increasingly obvious. In order to promote urban economic development and meet the needs of different groups, the shogunate began to set up a large number of urban romantic places. In order to promote consumption and increase taxes, the ancient custom of night crawling seemed out of date and was banned. However, in the mountainous areas of Japan, some remote villages, and some Japanese at the bottom of the city, because they cannot afford the high consumption of romantic places, such as brothels, they still secretly carry out night-crawling activities. It's just that the night-crawling at this time has changed from the purpose of reproducing the population to simply playing for men. At this time, most men need to pay a small amount of money to the woman for the unallowable night-crawling, and some of them will even be directly rejected by the woman on the grounds of violating the ban. In this way, night-climbing became obsolete and has been passed down for hundreds of years. It is worth mentioning that the Japanese have been keen on borrowing seeds from outsiders since ancient times. During the Sui and Tang dynasties, women's groups were sent to China to borrow seeds and improve genes. After the Second World War, in the name of recruitment for post-war reconstruction, many tall Europeans and Americans were introduced, achieving a leap in the height of the crowd. In the era when night climbing was popular, the villagers would warmly welcome outsiders in the village. However, when foreigners stay in the house, the women in the family sometimes provide night-crawling services. If a woman becomes pregnant because of this, she can give birth to the offspring of outsiders, thereby improving the genetic structure of the village. At that time, some Japanese mountainous families even prepared food and tableware in the kitchen at night, so that those men who crawled at night could go to a house to satisfy their hunger at dawn. Ending. Matsuo Tō was a young Japanese man who, on May 20-21, 1938, committed a mass murder in the rural village of Kamo, located in Okayama Prefecture, Japan. Tō was 21 years old at the time, and he killed 30 people, including his grandmother, and seriously injured 3 others. On the night of the attack, Tō cut off the electricity supply to the village, plunging it into darkness. He then went from house to house, killing his victims using a shotgun, a sword, and an axe. After completing the murders, he returned to his home and committed suicide by shooting himself. The event is known as the Tsuyama massacre, named after the nearby city of Tsuyama. Matsuo Tō suffered from tuberculosis, which led to the removal of one of his lungs. Due to his illness, he was ostracized by his community and faced difficulty finding a marriage partner. The reason for the incident was that the woman in the village refused his night crawl, so she felt resentful and killed the village that refused his reasonable request. After this shocking murder broke out, the custom of night crawling officially attracted the attention of the Japanese government and began to completely abolish and crack down on it. The practice of yobai is now considered a part of Japan's cultural history and is no longer observed in contemporary society.